There are three stages in life I know about. Before we were born, in our mother's womb, we don't even believe we will come up. We are comfortable in the fluids inside. 8 months, 9 months, you don't want to come. Now we come out. That world releases us into the next world. And we are here. Very happy.
You are young.
Because now we are free. Before we were confined. We are here. We eat from the mother. We eat from the mother. Even treatment. Now we are released to the next phase of life. Now we can go to Lira. Now we can choose which church to pray from. Which church to pray from? When to go to Kampala? Which shirt to put on a blouse? Which drink to take, beer or not? Which school to go to? And we are here, we don't want to do anything to do with the next. Same habits when we were in the womb. Now we think we are not going anywhere again. Then the rich man finds himself in eternity and in forever of reality, but in this time, no choice, because choice was only given in the middle part of life. Child in the womb has no choice but to receive what the mother gives. It's a rehearsal of the afterlife when we are in this life. God has given us the clue of the examination. There's no secret in the things of God. He has given us the secret. So the rich man lands in there. Remember, Jesus was talking about us. And he saw Abraham. This must have been a Jew. Because Jews, one of the reasons they killed Jesus was that he said he was greater than Abraham, their father. The Jews held Abraham for father so strong, like some people held religion. When I say religion, it means all churches which has become a sort of God. I know of Pentecostals who are sinning greatly, but they hold the name of their religion Pentecostal. And by that they will end up in hell.